laughs. Master made me lord, here. Here I am king. Flames gout from its nostrils and gaping jaws. I am god of fire and gold. Righto. Oh, see that. On the fifth floor I encountered a maturing drake. It was this creature which was feasting upon the sacrificed sorops, and it was just old enough to speak intelligibly. It claimed that a master had granted it power before attacking me. Oh, this is going to be interesting. So much for sneaking. So I just rush and... probably should just rush and kill this thing. I mean, these things will hit us, but they won't cause that much damage. I'll try to kill them off with some area effect type stuff, whatever we can do. I don't really have much. Arcana. I don't know if we can knock that thing down, but let's try. Probably gonna be interrupted by these things running into us. I'm gonna let us concussive missiles. Soul ignition. You know what? No. Actually. I can't. I turn it off. I want to turn it off. I want to use the puppet master. Alright. I can't do the puppet master right now. So I'm just going to have her. Stand your ground. Oh wait, yeah, sunbeam sounds good, but we'll do that. Oh my god, there's so many. Go yet, Aloth? I got an idea for you.
How may I help?
That's it!
Alright, time to heal already. Nope. What? Where are we going? Oh, Palagina, what are you doing over there? I can't reach her. She's paralyzed. Great, so she can't lay on hands for herself. We're gonna have to help her. Okay, I would like to... Ringleader. These guys. The one I'm aiming at will hopefully be taken over, and the others will be charmed. In other words, taken over, but they won't attack to full efficiency. These three on our side would be freaking awesome. So I'd like to see that happen. Innervating terror for these guys. Barely injured. Disengaged. Theodas. What are you doing, Theodas? She's... Theodas, no.
Yeah.
You're messing up my plan, Theodas. Ringleader with these guys. Come on. Concussive missile there. Actually, do your thing, please. I'd appreciate that. There's Canna, there's Palingina.
Yeah.
Oh, it's nothing.
They're on our side now, haha. Adair, you're over there? What the hell? There are pillars of faith over there. Another concussive missile. We're gonna go all out, of course.
Yes.
Again. Blessing. Includes our new friends. I think some of them changed back. Got him for another 13 seconds.
Yes.
We killed it? Oh, nice. I had no idea we'd kill that thing. Chop him down one at a time. Not bad at all. Much easier than the Searing Falls cave dragon. Drake Talon. Sickle-shaped and impressively sharp, this talon was removed from the slain body of a drake. It sure is. Rip that sucker out.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Skeletoni. Ooh. Ilfan Bryngar's Solace. And an amulet of health. So this is a shield. A medium shield. 12 deflection. Minus 4 accuracy. Exceptional, plus 8 shield deflection, plus 10 defense while stunned, plus 10 defense while prone. Ilfan Bryngar was not the most adept soldier, rather he was quite prone to stumbling over his own feet. Well aware of his failings, his family crafted him a shield of exceptional heft and durability, trusting that if he could not rain blows upon his enemies, he might at least prevent them landing any upon him in turn. Hold on a second. And the shield proved effective in this regard, for Ilfan was so thoroughly obscured by the shield, even while lying dazed in the mud, that many enemies sought out new targets out of sheer frustration. That's awesome. Well, I use a shield, so... This is like the one that Aeloth wears, plus 15 max endurance. Oh, Assuming we give that to our, you know, companions who are hanging out at the fortress. We're gonna look for secrets. Actually, hold on a second. I wanted to compare these the shields. Down here. Small shield. Where is the one we picked up? I thought I gave it to Amethyst, but it doesn't look like she has room. Not seeing it. Sorry, guys. It's this stuff I really didn't want to sell, but I don't have a use for it, so I might as well sell it. I'll take a look at it off screen just to be sure. Oh, here it is. For some reason, I just couldn't even see it there. So, who else has a shield? Adair. Maybe for Adair. Adair will compare. Because it's the same. It's a medium shield. Yeah. We'll do that. He doesn't even have a fine shield, so his shield's actually nothing. This will really help. Cool. Take a look at that. Nice. I love the models, how they update with the actual equipment. I think that's a really nice effect. Much appreciated by me. We don't have enough ingredients to do it, so. Alright, so he's got a new shield. Whoop. The flame has found something new.
The flame has shown us.
Something new? Ooh, gauntlets of accuracy. Opal, Valoon, and Peridot. +5 accuracy. We don't have a lot of glove type things. So when I find them, I get excited. And sometimes I'm myself exciting. Let's see what we got. So this is just +5 accuracy. Yet here it says accurate 2, so I'm not sure what that's about. Oh, I like this, though. That's a good... I can restore light endurance to people. Helps a little when we're getting thrashed. +5 reflex. Oh, we need that. Mechanics. Although I could switch it out, I suppose. Sometimes. Of crit multiplier bonus. That really make much difference. 0.1 to crit damage multiplier. I mean, I guess at high levels, but even then. Well, Canada doesn't have anything. And neither does Palagina. We'll give these to Palagina because we did just give him something, so we want to be fair. Unfortunately, these don't reflect on a character model. I thought putting that on granted her access to crafting or something. Says. The vague shapes of Kith are visible in the coal black ash coating the brickwork. Stairs down. Are we done with the level already? We do have one other way to go, or did we meet up with... We did meet up with that. Wow. It's a pretty small level. I was wondering what that is. I guess it's just blood. Interesting. Small level, huge battle. Goes down. Really small level. I mean, really. We explored this whole thing in under an hour. It probably helps that we're kind of like, we've leveled up, so we're kind of overpowered for this area. But, so I don't mind that much. Just like real life, if you venture into, you know, go to some kind of adventure or something like that, you might be equal to the task. It might be a piece of cake. This shows you, right? It's the facey. Well, I wish we could make this bigger so we could actually see more of it at one point, at one time. We'll go back. Which is the one with the... Takes you a whole hour just to get up to 3. I want to check that out. That's where that rope goes. So if we had gone down there, we would have went right into that dragon. So wait, that's level 1 or 2. I don't want to sneak, I want to go faster. Yeah, that's what I wanted to look at. This is where I decided not to go down. This wide pit descends into a grim darkness. You hear the whistling howl of wind, and from time to time hot gusts of air tug at your clothing. Examine the pit. The chasm appears to have been dug out with tools rather than being a natural formation. It seems to be very deep, but you cannot see the bottom to gauge the distance. Use a grappling hook to descend. Here, jump into the pit. You take a grappling hook from your pack and tie it off neatly around one of the heavy stone blocks surrounding the pit. A few hard tugs suggest that the rope will hold fast. Keeping a firm hold on the rope, you begin your descent into the darkness. Soon the edge of the pit is far above your head, and you can hear only the creak of the rope and your own breaths. Soon enough, however, you see another source of light far below. Past the dangling end of the rope, you can see a dimly lit room, at the center of which is a circular stone pool. Yep. The pool is filled with blood, and even at this distance you can pick out various limbs and mangled bodies. largely Zorup in nature. The tunnel bored into the stone ends a ways above the chamber below, and your rope extends no further. I just want to see this one. See, you wouldn't have had that splash. Bracing yourself for the landing, you loosen your hold, dropping down the remaining distance to land within the pool of blood with a noisy splash. The thick, murky waters hinder your swimming, threatening to pull you down into the unseen depths of this grim pit. But at last you crest the surface and pull yourself up and over the brim, to find yourself at the edge of a reeking, sludgy mixture of blood and limbs. Okay. So let's go up the master staircase. So we know when we come back here, which won't be for a while, we can go down the master staircase straight to level 5 and then go down these stairs right there. Very convenient. Cadnua. Merchant stalls construction completed. Yay! Sagani is assigned. Why does it say assigned? Towers perception bonus. What? When did I not notice that? The south curtain wall provides further. I thought we already had that. One, two, three, four, five, six. We only have six more things to get. I guess this is what we're working on. So what just finished? Why is it telling us all about monks? Very random. Merchant stalls. Where? Are they just... are they not marked? Is it like in the mall? They're just little, like, kiosks. And this is the curio shop. Or maybe something's got screwed up because I'm actually here. Maybe it's in the curio shop. I don't know. Maybe if we come at, in there and come out, we'll, it'll load that up, I don't know. So I have two reasons for checking this out. Yeah, this is nothing new here.
Good day, stranger.
Oh, you're just selling more than usual. It's the same person. Oh, no, 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 no. This is the stuff I sold her. Poor lady. Like, she needs all this crap. Who's gonna buy it? Who's gonna come to our stronghold to buy stuff? I mean, we don't have any marketing experts or anything. But, it'll stop you selling even more of our crap, does it? Let me hold on to those pistols. Yep. I sold the Torque of Defiance. I'm doomed. Yeah, I want to check out the merchant stalls. Maybe they're inside one of the buildings. I want to buy, what do you call it? Camping supplies. When we have fast on, it's so weird because they walk. The way they walk like that. How pretty, I'm not sure I ever noticed that. Well, we'll go in Bright Hollow and sleep. Get our rest there. I mean, maybe there's merchant stalls? I don't know. I don't see anything. Sleepy time. Woodland Trails bonus. +2 athletics, +3 constitution. Oops. The only thing I can think is it's inside Cadnua. Where, I'm not exactly sure. I mean, we could look around here some more. See if we see any merchant stalls. Waiting on your orders, m'lady. I have no orders. Keep defending the keep. Well, I guess technically that's an order. Treasury, dungeons, barracks. Where's these stalls? What the hell? General Goods Merchant.
Hello.
Greetings, m'lady. Fancy a new blade? Maybe an axe. I've plenty here to take the fancy of any woman of action. I've oils and tinctures for the ailing man, too. Wanna have a look? Show me thy wares. All camping supplies, hooray! I think we have 2 right now, so we're gonna take 2 more. We already have plenty of stuff. Plenty of potions. I wonder if there's more. If they're just hanging out in these. Not here. The library, the barracks. Maybe someone's selling something in the barracks? I don't know. Oh, there's Firebrand. What's up? She doesn't speak, sir. Okay, our next item of business. We will be returning to Searing Falls to take care of that named Drake. We will destroy that thing. We owe revenge, although technically it didn't do anything to us because I restored the save. It never happened. But hey, it was a vision. And it was very disturbing. You must destroy it. Thanks for watching. See you next time, guys. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.